Allah in His mercy, knowing the nature of human beings, because He created them, placed in the last third of Ramadan the greatest reward. Knowing that the nature of human beings is to enter into an event or an endeavor very enthused, energetic, but as time passes, we start to slow down, we start to weaken. By the midway, we lost our goals, we got diverted, we sluggish, we can no longer carry on as we did in the very beginning. And if there wasn't anything to boost our efforts, then we would continue on that downward path till we finish the event in the total opposite of what we intended in the very beginning. This is the way human beings are. We get lazy. Familiarity breeds contempt. We say that all the time. When you become too familiar with something, it becomes too much of a regular thing, then you start to treat it in a contemptuous manner. No big deal. There's always another Taraweeh. There's always another. Other chances. There will be. Other Ramadans. That's where we'll end up. We'll end up with Ramadan. Ah, I made a mess this time. Next Ramadan, inshallah. But the point is that every Ramadan, we keep saying that at the end. Next Ramadan, inshallah. I won't make the same mistakes. But that's the way we usually end up. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed in the last third rewards which surpass what could be achieved in the first two thirds, in order to get us energized again, to strive for those goals, the real goals of Ramadan, so we can end off the month on a high point, spiritually, emotionally, psychologically, intellectually. We finish off Ramadan in a good frame of mind, body, spirit. La ilaha